isa sa mga very challenging na i-deal sa clinic ay infertility. Kasi it causes uncomfortable conversations para sa mga couples na apektado nito. Sa karamihan ng mag-asawa, ang unprotected sexual intercourse results in pregnancy within a year. For 50% of couples naman, ang pagbubuntis ay nangyayari within the first 3 months. Alam nyo ba na according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, 7.3 million na mga kababaihan age 15 to 44 ay gumamit ng infertility services? According to their data, 12.1% ng mga babae sa age group na yon at some point ay nahirapan magbuntis. Hindi ito dahil yung babae yung cause ng infertility. It takes 2 to make a baby, after all. Ayon sa National Center for Biotechnology Information, 15% ng couples worldwide ay apektado ng condition na to. That would translate to around 48.5 million couples. 20 to 30% of infertility cases is because of the male factor and would contribute to 50% of cases overall. And Dr. says, this will be my topic today on infertility. So how do we define infertility? Infertility is defined as the inability to achieve pregnancy after 1 year of unprotected intercourse. If you have been trying to conceive for a year or more, you should consider an infertility evaluation. However, kung 35 years old or more ka na, dapat simulan mo ng mag-infertility evaluation after 6 months mo nang nagtatry with unprotected intercourse rather than 1 year para hindi ma-delay yung kailangan mong treatment. Kung suspecha mo may underlying infertility problem ka, you should seek care earlier. For example, irregular yung regla mo, suggesting na hindi ka nag-release ng egg monthly, or kung yung partner mo may known fertility problem, you probably should not wait an entire year before seeking treatment. Kapag ikaw at yung partner mo ay unable na mabuntis, you're not alone. At least 1 out of 7 couples has trouble conceiving. Sa isang survey noong 2011 dito sa Philippines, it's an infertility survey, 1 out of 10 Filipinos suffer infertility. Among this, 86% ay hindi nagkonsulta kasi dahil sa problem sa pera. When attempting pregnancy tapos unsuccessful pa rin kayo, normal na maka-experience kayo ng feeling ng guilt, depression, shame, grief, and sense of worthlessness. It may have negative psychosocial consequences such as loss of social status, social isolation, and marital instability. Pero, once na masimulan mo naman na explore yung mga medical options mo, makikita mo na yung fertility treatments offer more hope for a successful pregnancy than before. Majority ng mga pasyente na nagsisik ng consult from a fertility specialist will reach their goal of becoming pregnant. Yung OB-gynecologist mo will perform the initial fertility evaluation, or pwede rin kasing dumiretso ka na sa infertility specialist. Very important na makahanap ka ng doktor na mapapagkatiwalaan mo at komportable ka. May mga general obstetrician gynecologists na may interest sa treatment ng infertility. Ang espesyalista sa infertility ay tinatawag na REI or Reproductive Endocrinology Infertility Specialist. Ito ay mga OB-gynecologist na after nila makomplete yung full OBGYN residency training for 4 years, nagkompleto pa sila ng additional 3 years of subspecialty training sa REI at an approved fellowship program. Kapag naman nakita na may abnormal dun sa semen analysis ng lalaki, ire-refer siya sa urologist. And these are the doctors who specializes in the area of male infertility. Once makapili ka na ng qualified physician, ikaw at yung partner mo will undergo a series of tests. Sometimes, this may require a significant amount of time and energy on your part. Before these tests are performed, yung doctor mo, madami siyang itatanong, tapos i-review niya yung record mo at nung partner mo from a previous infertility evaluation kung meron na. Dapat ikaw naman i-provide mo yung mga information para ma-access nung doctor mo yung mga previous medical records mo. This is very critical para ma-minimize yung sayang na oras tsaka pera dun sa mga paulit-ulit na test at therapy na ibibigay sa'yo. Ikaw at saka yung partner mo should try to attend yung unang check-up with your doctor. Kasi infertility is a shared experience and is best managed as a couple. Dun sa unang visit nyo, mas maiintindihan nyo yung degree ng commitment and cooperation that an infertility investigation requires. It is important that you communicate honestly with your partner as well as with your doctor. Yung doctor mo, i-review niya yung history mo at magtatanong siya sa'yo tsaka sa partner mo ng mga questions para ma-identify yung potential causes bakit kayo hirap na magbuntis at magka-baby. Dun sa unang visit, pwedeng itanong ng doctor mo kung gaano kadalas at gaano ka-regular yung mens mo, kung meron kang pelvic pain or dysmenorrhea, kung meron kang abnormal bleeding, may abnormal discharge, or history ng pelvic infection, at mga kung ano-anong sakit. Expect mo na itatanong ka ng OB kung nagbuntis ka nung nakaraan, may mga miscarriage, naoperahan ka before, or kung may mga ginamit kang contraception. Ang maaring itanong sa partner mo is kung nagkaroon siya ng genital injury in the past, operasyon, infection, drug or medication use, kung nagkaroon siya ng anak in the past, at kung ano-ano pang mga sakit. You'll also be asked how long you've been trying to conceive, kung gaano kayo kadalas magkaroon ng sexual intercourse, kung gumagamit ba kayo ng lubricants, and if anyone in the family has birth defects. Pwede din kayong itanong kung kayo ng partner mo ay may pain or difficulty with sexual intercourse, just such as difficulty with developing or maintaining erection or with ejaculation. Kasi itong mga issues na to may interfere with your natural ability to conceive. Your physician will need to know you and your partner's complete sexual and reproductive histories, including yung mga nakaraan yung mga relationships. At least 25% kasi ng infertile couples have more than one factor causing infertility. It is very important na malaman lahat ng factors na to na nakakaapekto sa'yo at sa iyong partner. Dun sa unang visit nyo, it's also good to discuss yung emotional stress ng infertility, a subject na very difficult for you to share with family and friends. Alam ng doctor nyo na yung procedure tsaka yung mga intimate questions involved an infertility workup can be very difficult. You should always feel free to make your physician be aware of your concerns and frustrations, and you should ask your doctor questions whenever you need clarification. A physical examination of you and your partner may follow the initial review. Yung extent ng mga examinations ay nakadepende whether or not may mga factors na nakaka-apekto sa fertility dun sa initial evaluation. During your initial visit, this is also an opportunity para i-discuss yung plans para ma-maximize yung chances nyo na magka-baby. This includes eating healthy, avoiding alcohol and recreational drugs, as well as starting prenatal vitamins. Dapat tanong nyo rin yung doktor nyo kung alin ang mga gamot na unsafe sa pagbubuntis and that may require adjustments. Tapos i-screen ka din kung may mga exposure ka sa mga viruses that would affect pregnancy and make sure na kompleto yung mga vaccinations mo. In addition, you may also be screened for genetic illnesses that you might carry that do not affect you, pero pwede mong maipasa dun sa baby mo. I have another video where I discuss about the menstrual cycle and the process of becoming pregnant. So I will link in the description below para mapanood nyo at maintindihan about the menstrual cycle and how ovulation happens and the process of becoming pregnant. It's very important to know the menstrual cycle because a problem that develops in any part of this process can lead to infertility. So one of the factors that affect fertility is the ovulation factor. Yung mga problema with ovulation are common causes ng infertility, accounting to about 25% of all infertility cases. Ovulation involves yung pag-release ng mature egg is sa mga ovaries mo. After mag-ovulate, yung ovary ay nagpo-produce ng hormone na tinatawag na progesterone. Dun sa 12 to 16 days bago ka magregla, yung progesterone, pine-prepare niya yung lining ng matres into an optimal environment para mag-implant and doon mag-nurture yung fertilized egg. Kung regular ang regla mo, you are probably ovulating. Yung cycle length of approximately 24 to 34 days beginning from the first day of the previous period to the first day of the next are usually ovulatory. If you have period every few months or not at all, you are most likely not ovulating or ovulating infrequently. Although matrabaho siya at hindi siya routinely recommended, ang pwedeng procedure na gawin para malaman kung nag-o-ovulate or not is yung tinatawag na basal body temperature charting. So, bali ang gagawin mo, kukunin mo yung temperature mo pagising mo sa umaga bago ka tumayo dun sa kama mo. Tapos, i-record mo siya for 1 month. Normally kasi, yung pag-release ng progesterone because of ovulation, nagkakos siya ng mid-cycle na increase ng temperature between 0.5 to 1 degrees Fahrenheit, which indicates that ovulation has occurred. Kaya lang, some women na nag-ovulate normally may not have this rise in temperature kasi nga apektado sila ng factors like kapag may sipon or kapag pagod, kaya hindi nare-reflect itong increase in basal body temperature na to. At best, yung basal body temperature chart helps determine when and if ovulation is taking place, but only after it has happened. Para ma-predict yung ovulation bago siya mangyari, in order to schedule intercourse or insemination, for example, pwede kang gumamit ng over-the-counter ovulation predictor kit. Ito ay gumagamit ng ihi para malaman yung levels ng luteinizing hormones na tumataas before mag-ovulate. So, ito yung tinatawag na LH surge. So, yung LH surge na yun stimulates one of the ovaries to release egg and release progesterone. Yung mga ovulation predictor kits na to, usually, dinedetect nila yung LH surge about 1 day or a day and a half before mag-ovulate. So, bibigyan ka nito ng enough time tsaka ng partner mo. And parang it's an advanced notification na pwede nga ma-release na yung egg. Kaya pwede nyong i-time yung intercourse nyo kapag nag-positive ka dun sa ovulation predictor kit. Kaya lang, hindi lahat ng babaeng nag-o-ovulate will have an LH surge. Kaya hindi din nade-detect ng kits na to yung LH surge. So, you may find na itong mga kits na to mahirap gamitin or a little bit frustrating or pwede rin kasing false positive or false negative yung mga results. Sa isang normal menstrual cycle, yung progesterone levels are highest about 7 days after ovulation. Yung doctor mo pwede siyang mag-request ng blood test para ma-measure yung levels ng progesterone sa dugo mo at this time. So generally, yung blood progesterone is tested on days 19 to 23 of a 28-day menstrual cycle. Yung elevated progesterone level will help to confirm ovulation and the adequacy of hormone production. Your physician may also perform a pelvic ultrasound examination para ma-evaluate if ovulation happens. But this is not done routinely. Dun sa ultrasound examination na yon, hahanapin nila if may mga follicles dun sa ovaries. So, yung follicles are the fluid-filled sacs located beneath the ovary surface. And the ultrasound may also help to document a follicles collapse and subsequent release ng fluid, implying the release of a mature egg. If you are not ovulating, pwedeng mag-request yung doctor mo to determine the reason and then prescribe certain drugs para ma-induce yung ovulation. Your medical history and physical examination will help determine yung mga appropriate tests. So, may oral tsaka mga injectable na mga gamot na available para ma-induce ang ovulation. Sa panahon natin ngayon, madalas dinedelay yung pregnancy kasi nga many women are working. So, the number of women in their late 30s or 40s na nag-a-attempt na mag-pregnant has increased in recent years. So, hindi man natin na-realize na yung fertility begins to decline significantly sa mid-30s and the declines gets faster in your late 30s. So, may mga ibang babae kasi na nakakaramdam na ng decline sa kanilang fertility sa kanilang late 20s or even early 30s. Fertility declines with age because fewer eggs remain in your ovaries and the quality of the eggs remaining is lower than when you were younger. May mga blood tests na available para ma-estimate yung ovarian reserve, a term which reflects your age-related fertility potential. In the simplest of these tests, yung FSH and estradiol are tested in your blood dun sa second, sa third, or fourth day ng iyong menstrual period. Kapag mataas yung FSH level, this indicates that your chances for pregnancy may be lower than routinely expected for your age, especially kung ikaw ay 35 years or more na. Yung testing ng anti-Mullerian hormone or AMH level is another test para malaman yung ovarian reserve mo. Kapag mababa ang AMH levels, this indicates decreased ovarian reserve. Kapag masyadong mataas yung FSH at mababa ang AMH, it does not mean naman na wala ka ng chance for a successful conception. Pero this may indicate na kailangan mo ng mas aggressive treatment. Another commonly used option para malaman yung ovarian reserve is the use of a transvaginal ultrasound para malaman yung antral follicle count, which is when each follicle in both ovaries are counted. So, binibilang nila yon. Kailan ba ginagawa yung antral follicle count? So, it is usually done during the first 3 days of the menstrual cycle. Studies show na yung decreased ovarian reserve is associated with fewer eggs available but does not change the ability to get pregnant. However, it may be more difficult to conceive. Dahil napaka-importante na open at or patent or functional yung fallopian tubes in the process of pregnancy, may mga test na ginagawa para malaman kung open ba to. So, yung tubal factors as well as factors affecting the peritoneum, meaning yung lining ng pelvis at saka ng abdomen, this accounts for about 35% of all infertility problems. May tinatawag na hysterosalpingogram or yung x-ray para makita kung open ba or patent yung fallopian tubes. So, during a hysterosalpingogram, may special dye na ini-inject dun sa cervix, tapos pupunuin niya yung uterus, tapos magta-travel yung fluid na yon dun sa fallopian tubes. Kung nag-spill out yung fluid dun sa end ng fallopian tubes, ibig sabihin, open yung fallopian tubes. Kapag hindi naman, then the tubes are most likely blocked. It is important to note that the tubes might still be open kahit na walang nakitang spill. Kapag yung hysterosalpingogram showed blocked fallopian tubes, yung doctor mo maaari siyang mag-perform ng laparoscopy para ma-assess yung degree ng damage dun sa fallopian tubes. Ang hysterosalpingogram ay usually ginagawa after ng iyong menstruation before nung expected ovulation. Kapag nakitang barado ang iyong fallopian tubes or scarred siya or damage, maaaring isuggest ng doktor mo for you to undergo surgery para makorek yung problem. But hindi guarantee na yung surgery will correct the problem in the fallopian tube. Kahit na na-open pa siya or na-clear yung mga scar tissue, hindi natin siguro kung magpa-function siya properly. Although some tubal problems are corrected by surgery, yung mga babae na may severely damaged fallopian tubes are so unlikely to become pregnant successfully because very badly damaged tubes may be filled with fluid, yung tinatawag na hydrosalpinx, and will lower success ng in vitro fertilization. So, yung doctor mo pwede na lang niyang isuggest na tanggalin yung fallopian tubes before ka mag-IVF. In approximately 40% ng infertile couples, ang male partner is either the sole or a contributing cause of infertility. Therefore, a semen analysis is very important in the initial evaluation. Para mapaghandaan ng lalaki yung semen analysis, your partner will be asked to abstain from ejaculating for 2 to 5 days. The semen specimen is examined under the microscope para malaman yung volume, yung count, yung motility, yung morphology ng sperm. So in general, 2 to 3 semen analysis may be recommended over 2 to 6 months since sperm quality can vary over time. So may mga ibang hormonal and genetic test din na pwedeng i-request depending on the type and severity of abnormalities found. Kapag yung partner mo nakita dun sa sperm analysis niya na may abnormalities, he may need to consult a doctor who specializes in male infertility. Yung treatment ng male infertility may include surgical correction ng varicocele meaning dilated or varicose veins dun sa scrotum, or duct obstruction or medication para ma-improve yung sperm production. Sa ibang mga kalalakihan, surgery to obtain sperm from the testes can be performed. Sa ibang mga kaso, walang obvious cause bakit poor yung sperm quality ng lalaki. Intrauterine insemination or IVF or in vitro fertilization may then be recommended. Direct injection ng single sperm dun sa egg or intracytoplasmic sperm injection, yung tawag doon, may be recommended as a part of the IVF process. Yung older women usually lower yung response nila sa fertility medications and higher din yung miscarriage rates nila compared sa mga younger women. Yung chance din na magkaroon ng chromosomally abnormal embryo, for example, Down syndrome, also increases with age. Dahil dun sa marked effect ng age sa pregnancy and birth rates, it is common for older couples to begin fertility treatment sooner. In most cases, to consider more aggressive treatment than the younger couples. Possible treatments sa age-related infertility in women include fertility drugs plus IUI or IVF. Para sa mga couples na hindi successful with fertility treatments or who choose to forgo treatment, adoption is another option. Dito sa Pilipinas, yung third-party assisted reproductive techniques, for example, egg, sperm, or embryo donation and surrogate motherhood is ethically unacceptable. Sa ibang bansa kasi pwede. May mga conditions din sa cervix na pwedeng magkaroon ng impact sa fertility. Pero bihirang sila lang yung dahilan ng problema na to. Very important na i-inform mo yung doctor mo kung may mga prior biopsies ka sa cervix, like cone biopsy or freezing or laser treatment, yung tinatawag na LIP, or kung may mga abnormal pap smears ka, or kung yung nanay mo may history na uminom siya nung DES or diethyl estilbestrol nung nagdadalang tao siya sa'yo. These issues can sometimes increase a woman's risk for having infertility and or pregnancy complications like miscarriage, preterm labor, and premature births. Yung fertility problems associated with cervix are generally treated with antibiotics, hormones, or by IUI. Yung na-mention ko kanina na HSG test or hysterosalpingogram is often used to evaluate fallopian tube problems. Pero pwede rin niya kasing masabi yung kung may mga problems sa uterine cavity. The uterine cavity is yung hollow space dun sa uterus kung saan yung embryo ay nag-i-implant at nagde-develop. So ang mga posibleng uterine abnormalities na ma-identify includes scar tissue, polyp, myoma, or an abnormally shaped uterine cavity. Yung mga problema within the uterus ay pwede kasing maka-interfere dun sa implantation ng embryo and may increase the incidence of miscarriage. So, may procedure na tinatawag na hysteroscopy. It's a minor and minimally invasive surgery. It's an incision-free surgical procedure na pwedeng makapagtulong ma-evaluate and correct the structural problems dun sa uterine cavity. Yung mga uterine abnormalities can also be seen with saline sonohysterogram. Pwede rin siyang tinatawag na sonohysterogram or water ultrasound. An SHG ay pelvic ultrasound na ginagawa after mong mag-inject ng fluid dun sa cervix papunta sa uterine cavity. Unlike hysterosalpingogram, yung sonohysterogram shows the contour of the wall of the uterus as well as the cavity at the same time. Difference which can help identify scar tissue, polyps, and myomas. Yung peritoneal factor infertility refers to the abnormalities involving the peritoneum or yun yung lining ng surfaces ng ating internal organs. So, yung mga problems na to, for example, scar tissue or endometriosis. Yung endometriosis ay isang condition where yung tissue that normally lines the uterus begins to grow outside of the uterus. So, yung tissue na to, pwede siyang tumubo on any structure within the pelvis, including the ovaries, and is found in about 35% of infertile women na walang ibang madiagnose na problema or infertility problem. Yung endometriosis is found more commonly in women with infertility, pelvic pain, and painful intercourse. Ang endometriosis ay pwedeng maka-apekto sa function din ng ovaries, ng ovarian reserve, and yung function ng fallopian tubes at pati ang implantation. May procedure na tinatawag na laparoscopy. It's a minimally invasive surgical procedure na ginagawa para ma-diagnose at saka ma-treat yung mga adhesion and endometriosis. So it is performed under general anesthesia. And during the procedure, may pinapasok na telescopic instrument or tinatawag na laparoscope. Pinapasok siya sa isang maliit na butas within or just below your navel. So, yung physician will then look through the laparoscope directly into your abdominal cavity and titingnan doon yung ovary, yung fallopian tube, at saka yung matres. During the laparoscopy, pwede din maglagay ng dye. Ipapasok siya dun sa cervix para makita kung may spillage yung dye dun sa fallopian tubes outside into the peritoneal cavity para makita kung open ba or patent yung fallopian tubes. Pwedeng magdagdag ng additional na incision above your pubic area para makapagdagdag ng additional instrument yung doctor mo to better examine your pelvic organs or to treat any disease kung may makita. May mga mas high-tech pang procedures, for example, robotic controlled instruments and lasers may now be used laparoscopically to treat conditions like endometriosis, adhesions, and ovarian cysts. In many cases din, kung talagang very challenging, mahirap gawin yung laparoscopy, may tinatawag na laparotomy. Hinihiwaan na yung tiyan. Larger na yung abdominal incision compared sa laparoscopy na butas lang. This is an approximately 6-week recovery. But dahil sa technology ngayon, most of the time, nakakayanan naman ng laparoscopy, especially with this skilled REI specialist. Although very reasonable and sometimes advisable na mag-perform ng laparoscopy para ma-identify at magamot yung pelvic disease, itong procedure na to is not routinely performed in every infertility evaluation. Kasi nga, yung laparoscopy, mahal din siya and involves some small surgical risk. Ikaw at yung doctor mo should discuss whether or not laparoscopy is recommended in your particular case. Sometimes, your physician may not recommend a laparoscopy initially, but instead recommend it at a later time depending on your response to treatment. approximately 10% of couples trying to get pregnant, all of the above tests are normal and there is no easily identifiable cause for infertility. So yung ito yung tinatawag na unexplained infertility. In a higher percentage ng couples, only minor abnormalities are found that should not be severe enough to result in infertility. Sa mga kaso na to, yung infertility ay tinatawag nga na unexplained infertility. Mga couples na may unexplained infertility ay maaaring may problem with egg quality, fertilization, pwedeng genetics, tubal function, or sperm function that are difficult to diagnose and or treat. Yung fertility drugs and IUI have been used in couples with unexplained infertility with limited success. So kapag hindi pa rin nagbuntis within 3 to 6 treatment cycles, ang i-recommend na ay IVF and has been shown to be the most effective treatment for unexplained infertility. May mga babae or mga lalaki who may carry genetic abnormalities that makes it more difficult for them to become pregnant and more likely that a pregnancy ends as a miscarriage. For example, ng genetic abnormalities, yung tinatawag na translocation or a rearrangement of genetic material. So, pwede itong i-test in appropriate circumstances by blood testing nung mag-asawa. May mga couples din may even carry a known genetic illness and wish to avoid passing this illness to a child. So, in special circumstances, a more advanced fertility treatment known as pre-implantation genetic testing may be offered in conjunction with IVF. Ano nga ba yung chances ng success with in vitro fertilization? So, ang bawat couple has a unique set of characteristics and yung chances nila na mag-pregnant varies widely. So, the success of IVF really depends on many factors, especially age and the quality of your embryos. Ang infertility ay isang medical condition that has many emotional aspects. Feelings such as anger, sadness, guilt, and anxiety are common and may affect your self-esteem and self-image. So, pwedeng nahihirapan din kayong i-share yung feelings nyo with your family and friends, and this could lead to isolation. So, very important na malaman mo na itong mga feelings na to are normal responses to infertility and are experienced by many couples. Although yung doctor mo will describe various treatments and realistic odds of success with treatments, you may decide how far you will go in your attempts to conceive. Siyempre, considering din yung expenses, mahal din tong mga treatments na to. So, coming to a joint decision with your partner about yung goals nyo, tapos yung acceptable treatments is very important. So, kayo na rin yung mag-set ng endpoint for treatment. Sometimes, yung mga factors na nakaka-apekto sa iyong fertility ay madaling malaman and gamutin. But, sa karamihan ng kaso, a very specific reason for infertility may be difficult to identify. After ng full evaluation, yung doctor mo can give you reasonable idea ng chances mo of achieving pregnancy with various treatment options. Yung choice of which treatment to pursue is strictly a personal one. So, yung ang i-consider mo dito would be yung side effects, yung cost, yung risk ng multiple births, which is increased with fertility treatments. Yung expected success rates are important to consider when choosing a treatment plan. Nakakatulong din na kapag nagsimula ka na ng fertility treatment, na mag-develop ka ng long-term plan with your doctor para may idea ka kung gaano katagal mong ipopursue yung treatment before ka mag-move on dun sa next na mas agresibong option or kung titigil ka na ba. Since yung initial treatment mo may provide additional answers as to the cause of your infertility, very important na to continually reevaluate yung plano mo by discussing treatment results with your doctor. it may also be necessary at times to temporarily stop treatment and begin again at a later date. Thanks to the many options na existing today, including advanced reproductive technologies and adoption, kasi most infertile couples will be able to experience the joy of parenthood. The sooner you will meet your specialist, the sooner you will find the answers and be able to realize your dream of having a child. So thank you for listening to this infertility talk. I hope na madami kayong natutunan at nalaman, and I hope this will allay your fears, mabawasan yung mga burdens nyo, and you can plan well how to proceed with your fertility treatment options later on and your choices for your doctors. So thank you so much for listening, and see you in my next videos.